There will be an equal mix of fiat as well as token economy.
Right.
The reason I will say that because any which ways we are moving towards digital payments, right?
Right.
The number of times you would have used cash for traveling from point A to point B has gone down dramatically. Right. You can use Google Pay or PayPal and get it done, right? Right. But there will be, for example, what about section of people who don't have access to even banking, or they're not literate enough to even transact on Google Pay or Paytm for that matter. Mm. So for some section of people, fiat currency will still be in circulation. Mm. I'm talking about the Indian context, but again, it can change. It's subject to change as well. Mm. Even people in the villages, they are using Paytm more than what I have ever used in my life, right? So even that's bound to change. Mm. And the reason why it's bound to happen, because the cost of printing money is going to go high. Every day, the paper is getting costly, right?
Right.
Right. Now, if you buy a notebook, it might cost you maybe 60 or 50 bucks. But way back in my days, we used to just pay 5 rupees or 10 bucks to get a notebook, right? So the cost of printing money is going to high. Cost of counterfeit money will also go high if you still keep on using fiat currency.
Right.
But if you use digital currency
or
a cryptocurrency, which is nothing but a digital asset, you can track back the origin of that money movement, right? Or the fund transfer. Let's say if I'm paying you X amount of money, the auditors will get to know, okay, this money came from this account, it moved to the Y account, right? So it's easier to establish money trail, and accountability of money will be much more easier. You can track back on black money as well.